Okay, good morning. I hope now students are coming only. All are keeping well, I hope so. And the happy news that 9th and 10th already started their class, full day class. Okay, full day class, not half day or shift, full day class from yesterday onwards, I think. I hope we are expecting next month. Okay, this month there is a cabinet meeting. And government will decide, okay, you have to start like a 6 to 10th or 1 to 8. Okay, how to start, when to start. I hope soon it will start. Okay, we'll pray for the better. Okay, pray for the better. We'll come to school and enjoy nicely, correct? No? Yes, I will think so. Yes, okay. So in the Java chapter, one point, okay, in the first chapter, one point is remaining. Is that is features of object-oriented programming. Features of object-oriented programming. Like this is the features, the major features. There are many features. Major four features are given here. That is not only for Java. Like you have seen C, C++, okay, or Python, Ruby. So you have seen, you have learned or you have seen different types of high-level languages. Okay, which are deal with the objects, object-oriented programs. Yes, for all these are the major four features. Okay, and these four features, the practical parts we will learn, and these four parts and one more array, A-R-R-A-Y, array. These all the parts or the features we will learn in 10th standard. That is a portion of a 10th standard. Okay, so today I will take only the theory part. Okay, just a briefing. Theory parts not in detail. So what is this theory? What are the main features of object-oriented program? OOPS, O-O-P-S. Okay, so we'll go to the share screen. I hope every day you are praying. Okay, in between I want to say, because, okay, Chitradurga is okay, good. But compared to other places, Corona, sir, your voice is breaking. Okay, it's a network problem. Maybe you please wait. Okay, Vaishnavi, please wait. You will get it. Okay. What else? Yes. So please keep in mind and pray. And different countries, wars are going on, fightings. And so always keep in mind. Okay, then we'll go to the point. Okay, features of object-oriented program. Page number 57. Page number 57. Page number 57. I hope you can see this. Okay. Yes. So features of object-oriented program. I will ask again. I will come. Okay. Can you see? Can you see my screen?
Sir.
Okay. Okay. So features of object-oriented programming. Let us have a look. Page number 57. Look, some more features of object-oriented programming. So why it is more features? We have turned about, you have told about what is that object, class, and what is that, and how variable, tokens, yes, in the statement. So, but this is a different one. That is, it is written there, some more features, object-oriented programming. Okay. Object-oriented programming. First one is abstraction. You can read this one. Abstraction is a very important feature of object-oriented program, of course. Okay, so abstraction. See this camera. There are many features inside. There are many, many machines inside. Lens will work separate, and this button, press zoom and zoom out. Flash is another device inside. And how it works, we don't know. What we know? We know the outside cover and few buttons outside. Same way, mobile also, mobile phones. You can see only that cover page, cover out thing. When you are only few buttons or few icons, you can see few icons. How it works, how it, where it will works, and after working, what will direct to, nothing we don't know. It will show the abstraction of thing. That is the meaning of abstraction. Abstract. Okay. It is used to manage a complexity of the system, that is, it provides only essential feature of the system to user and hides all the, that is very important, all the complexing process. Okay, please underline that line. It provides only essential features of system to user and hides all the complex process. Please underline that one. So only a necessary things it will show in the camera, as I told. Yes, example. One example is given there. We are using ATM machine. You insert your debit and credit card in the provided slots and the follow the instruction that appear on the screen. See here. After providing the correct PIN number and entering the desired amount, money is collected from the machine. In the above given example, only user has right to interact with the interface using the providing tools. See, look here. ATM. So only you can see this one. Okay, after inserting, what when you press this button, what is happening there? Okay, sending one messages to bank and they will check this person having account or this card is blocked or not. How much money is there? If you are typing amount 5,000 is there in the bank. If after withdrawing the 5,000, it you have to deduct from the bank. See here. So many functions are there, but you can see only few things. Only what user can see, very few things. Remaining all hid or hide from your the user. Clear? So that is called abstraction. He never comes to you. Okay, no need of, yeah. What is that? No need of to know that background, what is happening there for the user. Okay, the function that interact with each other, nothing to know. Okay. It is not compulsory that you should know everything, nothing. So only the basic things will show, which is user supposed to know, only that much. That is called abstraction. Next one is encapsulation, encapsule, capsule. When we have some medicines, you the doctors prescribe encapsules, correct? No, instead of liquid one, syrup. Yes, that is more. Now it is encapsule. Capsule means what? There may be then the capsule, there may be powder, powder medicine, and it is covered, encapsule, capsule. Yes, you are closing, protecting by some fur or what is that, outside effects. Okay, same way this encapsulation in computer. See, look here. Yeah, the technique of binding both the data and function together to keep them safe from unauthorized access and access and misuse, underline. So encapsulation is a technique of binding, underline, binding. Look here, encapsulation, the medicine, it is covering. Okay, covering the medicine from water, air, and other things. So they use, and it is diluted one. When you eat, when you have, it will be digest easily. So it protects from outside things to the chemical or the medicine what is there inside. Same thing in computer, this is encapsulation, the variables, method, class, functions, and a declaration. Then what is that? What is that? Then what else? We have learned the tokens. Yes, what are tokens we learn? Exactly, each minute parts in the program. Okay, like identifiers, keywords, constant, variables, separators, operators. Okay, so these all are protected in like a one capsule. Why we need this encapsulation method? To save from unauthorized access and misuse, so that program cannot use by anybody else. We have learned public and private. Yes, if you are done public, anybody can use. If it is private, so we are encapsulating. Mobile phones, you will keep password. So with the password you are capsuling. No one can use, no one can access. Even some application in your parents will put, okay, some application, some passwords or face recognition. Why? Protection, giving protection like a encapsulation. Encapsulation ensures that a user cannot access the data output process or the registration. It also ensures that user can have access only those function, look here, object A, data functions, object B, data functions, and object C. So how they can, anybody can use? If the encapsulate means no one can. For which he means use. He is authorized the while our function remain unaffected. So it is separate. Each one is separate. If you encapsulate. Let us understand the concept of the encapsulation with the help of the same example of an ATM machine. In this scenario, data can be accessed by the using the given function. However, the most important point is note that while using an ATM, you can only access the data that belongs to you. You put your ATM insert, and can you withdraw the money from your parents? No. You have to insert the father's or mother's ATM. Okay, because this card is encapsulated with a password and some other recognitions. Okay, some other passwords or many things. You cannot see the account balance of the customers. Okay, you can't see something related to that one, only you can see. And next one is inheritance. Inheritance means, okay, you will say, you and your parents, you are same like, or my son is look same like or similar like you. Sometimes you'll say, yes, same black in color and the hairstyle and like thin or fat, tall, eyes are similar. Okay, inheritance, that behavior, it is not behavior, that what you say, that appearance is as it is to the children. Same way, you will say, your mother is so kindful, helping nature, and your daughter or child also the same. She or he got the same behavior. Wow, helping nature. Okay, helping nature or loving nature. We'll say having giving nature, praying nature from the father or mother. Same way, opposite also, we will say, we will inherit. What will inherit? Who? Lija sir. Same like his father. I know his father, no, like that only. Yes. If I do of a person does any wrong things, suddenly we'll say, that parent's son only, no? Daughter only, no? We can't accept more than that one, like that only. See, inherited from the parents, inheritance. Got it? Inheritance. Same way in computer also, same, inherit. Example, in Gmail, the children under 13 cannot create a Gmail account. Okay, so if you need parents' permission, okay, and whatever we use, it will get. And there are some parents who has kept your children, the students' mobile as a child, and whatever you do in this mobile, the notification or monitors will go to, or in a, what is that, anything will go to their parents' mobile. There are options are there. Okay, some very few are doing. Okay, so we will go to that point. What it is? Inheritance. Yes. Inheritance is the feature using which an object on one class acquires the properties and behavior of object in another class. Okay, it will read itself. Okay, which means somebody will read. Okay, I'm reading so fast. Yes.
Create new classes that are built upon existing class and can reuse the methods and fields of the parent class.
Okay, so which means you can create a new class here. Vehicle is a new class. Okay, in that class you create bikes, is another subclass. Cars is another subclass here. So the pedals of bike, that is the few things inherited from bike. And by few things inherited from vehicle, like that, because these all are vehicles. The features of vehicle are same, but not the same like a pedal. Car has pedal? No. Only few inherits. Clear? Yes.
This property brings the concept of object-oriented programming a step closer to our lives, as it reflects the real-life concept of heredity in programming.
Okay, see here, object-oriented, concerned with the data. Discrete or characteristic, mode, object models here. So these, what it means? The object-oriented program, you can take some behaviors, okay, some classes. From that class, only few variables you can take. You can inherit, no need to type the long program. Instead of long program, you can inherit from another program, another class. Yes.
Heredity is defined as the transfer of characteristics from parents to their children.
Correct, no? Heredity, we'll say, no? Parents to children, yes.
Now let us understand the concept of inheritance with the help of an example. A class bird can be broadly classified as flying birds and non-flying birds. The principle behind this sort of classification is that each derived class shares the common characteristics with the class from which it is derived.
Okay, so like bees, correct, no? A class bird can be broadly classified like a flying bird, correct, no? Flying birds, okay, sorry, 1 minute. Sorry for disturbance. Okay. Yeah, father. Yeah. Good morning, father. Yeah, good morning, father. Yeah. Okay, thank you, father. Yeah. And time and all that you will inform, no, later. Timing and all things. Today 4:30, no? Okay, father, I'll come, father. Okay, thank you. Okay, sorry for inconvenience. One call from urgent call. Okay, it's okay. Let it be. Yes, what we are talking about. Yes. Okay. And a simple, like another example, I will say mobile phone. Yes. Mobile phone. This is a mobile phone. Just I got a call. Yes. And I'm using for call. Only for call we use this mobile. No. Calculator, video player, music player, then editing. Gaming, so many things. Okay, and how much programs are there in this one? So it is not each one, not separate program. Example, video and audio. Yes, what is the common things and video and audio in mobile? Video also, after playing video you can hear. If you play the music you can hear. So hearing is the one method of both video and audio. Video is a one class, audio is another class. And both common function or method is what? Hearing. And no need to write the program for video, hearing one program, and audio, hearing one program, and for calling, you also hearing. For that one also, same, speaker is working for three. Got it? So the common program from there, you are inherited to video class. Inherited that program hearing feature is inherited from the mobile to audio and calling everything. Got it the concept? Yes. Okay, that is the inheritance.
Polymorphism. The word polymorphism means many forms.
Okay, poly means many. Morphism means morphing. Yeah, surely, of course. Yes, here sometimes the boys will do like Hrithik Roshan's photo you will take, and Hrithik Roshan's head you cut and keep it somewhere, and you will put your head there on the Hrithik Roshan's muscle and all muscle man's. Okay, then you will say, see, this is body from Hrithik Roshan and head from you. How it will be? Yeah, looking nice. What you are doing? You are morphing, adding different thing, many, poly means many, many you are adding. Same in mobile, it's a morphing, adding so many features, as I told, mobile, calculator, then calling, video, editing, gaming, okay, what else are not there? Everything bringing together, make it as a polymorphism, morphing together, yes? Got it? So that is called a polymorphism. Poly means many. Morphism means forming, creating.
Polymorphism helps the programmer to use the same function name for more than one purpose. Now let us understand the concept of polymorphism by taking the example of mobile phone. Your mobile phone too has polymorphic ability, that is, one name but many functions. Let us understand this with the help of following figure. Similarly, in OOP, polymorphism is a feature that allows a function to behave differently for different objects. Let us find out how. It's a feature that allows a function to behave differently for different objects.
Okay, yes, so polymorphism. Okay, what is polymorphism? This is the thing. Compile time, run time. That means you can make it a different features in one. Okay, that is called polymorphism. So I am stopping these points. Yes. Okay, children. What I said that one. Yes. So these are the major object-oriented programs features. So features of object-oriented program. Okay, then it is 9:21. Actually, I plan to take one more, not point. All the points I have completed, but the page number 69, I hope. Okay, that exercises, fill in the blanks, true or false, application based, multiple choice. Did you copy to the textbook?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I'm not going to repeat after that one. Okay, the teacher, you are 8th standard student. No need of showing all the things. So now I want to switch to the practical parts. Okay, creating a program, because theory parts somehow you learn. Yes, and you have to get some concept. Okay, some idea of practical things. Okay, I will ask the question, I will solve, and you have to answer, and I will call the name. Please answer those children. Okay. Because if you are making too much sound, I can't hear. You know the consequence if you make 10 children answer. Okay, so I'm going there. Please keep in mind you have only two chapters for the test. That is 4th and 5th chapter. And the question pattern I have put in the notice board. Please, today you see. And now soon we will go to the programs. Okay, yes. What else? Yes, I'll go to there. Yes, I'll call the name. Where it is Java. Yes. Okay, now children, I will ask one name. Deeksha, can you help me to create a class, a new class here? The class name is Deeksha. How we can create?
Sir, we have to go to any one folder. You can go to my name, sir.
It's okay. No, how to create a class? Okay, how to create a class? Like I hope you can see my sharing screen. Is it possible?
Yes, sir. New class, sir.
Then SSP. Here, how we can create a class name that is 8A or something, 8B, 8A and B. How we can create a new class here? He's not listening, I think. If I ask anybody, means so many will talk. That's why I'm calling the name. So some names I will call. The time is going. Okay, let it be. No problem. Yes, Amita. Okay, who is there? Can you switch on the camera so I can see you are available and I can ask you, please fast. Otherwise, I will I'll take the class. If you can switch on the camera or you can text it. The chat section is on. Okay, you can ask. Please ask me. You can type your name. Yes, so I'll ask them. Who is? Please type the name because I can't. Okay, Sai Keshav. Yes, Sai Keshav is the first person. He asked. Okay, Sai Keshav. Okay, no, how we can create a new class here?
Sir, new class symbol is there.
Here you see new class. Correct. Good. Very good. Click on new class. So new class will come. Then what to next? class name. Okay, class name. That is, I will write computer 8AB. Okay, I gave and click on OK. Now see here, computer 8B came here. Now how we can open? How we can open? Anyhow, some I'm not see some parents are here. Akash N. Now how we can open? How we can write the program?
Sir, double tap on that. Sir.
Double click, tap. Okay, you are so well advanced. Okay, good. No, it's correct answer. Okay, you have well learned or practice in mobile. Tapping it is in the mobiles. Okay, in computer or laptop. Yeah. Okay, touch screen, computer and all. Yes, correct. Okay, correct. Yes. Okay, double click on this class. Then you will get another page. And by default, there are templates here. There are many templates are there, like what is that, sample programs. So what do you have to do? Anybody? Some are, many are there. Sir, network issues there. So those who are available, please tell me. Okay, please tell. Anybody can say how we can write the program here. There is one program. So what I have to do? Anybody?
Control A, left back.
Control A, correct. Control A. You select all. Then what do you have to do? Next, please.
Delete or backspace.
Delete or backspace. So it is deleted. Clear? Okay. Then here we have to write the program. So one program I will show. Stop sharing. I will share the screen so you can see everything. Yes. Window one page. Where is that page? Yes. Can you see now two programs on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see here. Yes, sir. Who can say what is the difference of these two program? Just you watch 2 minutes, 2 seconds or 2-3 minutes. You watch and you can you find what is the main difference? There are many different main difference of these two program. The program is to calculate English mark and computer mark, and you have to get the total. What's the difference of these both program? Anybody?
Sir, the numbers are given, sir, but for the first one, the value is not given.
Yes. Okay. So how we can say in a computer name or computer words as a Java words, what you said is correct. Exactly correct.
Sir, user has to give in the first one and the second, already the max has been given.
Yeah, exactly. So here, if you declare here, it is only declaration of what? These two, what is EM and CM? English mark and computer mark. What is that? You declared what? Declared?
Subject.
It may variable. Correct, no? Yes, it's a one variable, English mark. We have to serve the English mark, and that place is called variable. Remember, no? Variable. Yes. So this is one variable. This is two variable. So these two variables we declared before compiling, that the user can give the mark. Got it? And the two marks, it is in, why it is a computer or the programmer declared another variable. What is another variable? Total. Okay. And what is the data type of total variable? Integer. What we are doing there, this English mark and computer mark will be add and serve in this total variable. Got it? Here we didn't initialize the variable. We did not initialize the variable. But in this program, the programmer initialized the variable. It is declared. How it is declared? This is declared. But here it is initialized with value. Initialized. That is the main difference of these two. Got it? If you initialize before compile, if initialize, then you can do, give the opportunity to the user to give the initialization. Here it is, the programmer is initialized and declared variable and initialized the variable also. Got it? Yes. Now the same program I will copy and I will bring here. New program here we created. See here. Public. Public is a, what is public? Each one talk, each one has this everything. We tell any, all the programs are made up of token, because token is the minute or smallest part in program. So public, public is a access identifier. Class is a keyword, correct? No, add mark is a name of the class, name of the class. Okay, one variable, class name. Public, again access. Static, these are keyword. Voice is a keyword. And what is the function of void? Void is a return type which return nothing unless we use this statement, system.print. Okay, void is a, can you say the answer? What is void? What is the function of void? Void is a keyword. What is the function of void? Void is a return type which returns nothing unless it will return. When it will return, we use system.out.println statement. Clear? Main is a function, and here we declare two variable em and cm. The data types are integer and integer total. You have to add English mark and computer mark. System.out.println total, and I compile. I'm going to run this program. Right click and see here, void main. See, user is giving, not the programmer. Yes. Okay. English, what is that? EM. English mark is 67 and the computer mark is 97. Wow. Happy. Yes. Look here, 164. Total mark is 164. Got it. Now, again, you want to open means double click. Suppose children, this is a mark. Whose mark it is? Whose mark? My mark or your mark? Some name should be there. No. Then how we can give the name, this mark of 8th standard, the total mark for 8th standard? How we can get the printout? Is there any idea?
Sir, we are seeing the Word document, not the Java programming.
You can't see. Okay, that's why I am sharing the window. So actually I want to share entire screen. Yes. So, but all my personal things you will come to know. Okay, don't see here and there. Okay. Yes. Okay. I hope now you can see.
Yes, sir.
Now you see, yes, I want to know, this is Lijo's mark card. How we can write? We have to give the name. First time I am writing, this is the mark of Lijo. Second time when user will give, the this is the mark of Sharon, computer mark, English mark. So how we can write? User has to give the name. Then, anybody? Anybody? No one? Yes, I myself will say. So here I will add one more. It is separator I use, comma. Comma is a separator in Java. Okay. Then what you'll write? String. Because I want to write string. Okay. Name. String space name. Enium. Name. I will write full. Name. Okay. Naam. Hindi. Naam. Here? Yes. So I have given string name. Then one more thing we have to give. What do you have to give? You have to get the output. What is the output? How you will get? Yes. What is output? System.out.println. println, because it has to go to the next line. And total we have to write there. What do you have to write? Which variable? Yes, NAM. So type there instead of total. I write here. What I'll write? Name. Name. Sorry, what is that? Yeah, bracket has gone. Yes. Got it? Now there is no compile. There is no error. No error found. And minimize and you come back. Yes. Now I will run this program. Look here. First, integer marks. Okay, English mark. Okay, 58. And computer mark. 98. And whose mark it is? See here, string name. What is the name? Lijo. Okay. So why it is Lijo? It is, look here, error. Cannot find symbol variable Lijo. Why? Because string variable string, the value you must write in double inverted comma or sub double quotation mark. Okay, understood? When you write the string, you have to put that one in double inverted comma. Okay, then I click OK. Now see here, Lijo 156. What is the mark? 150 mark. Whose mark it is? Lijo's mark. Again, if I run, second person. Okay, mark something and yes, and here you give AAA. Again, what do you have to give? Double inverted comma. Okay. Why it is? Because why? Why we have to give double inverted comma here?
Because it is not a stored variable.
String. It is a string variable. Data type. Data type is given string. So, and click on OK. So, what is the total? 103. It is A. Because next line we said, no? A and 103. Got it, the program? Once again, I will open. Got the program?
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Sir.
Next one. Now I want to give in that output page, output, the terminal page. It is just written there 130, correct? No. So I want to get that the total mark of EM and CM is 160. I want to get like that answer. So what do you have to do? Children, okay, are you getting? So in the question, what is the question? You are getting, no? What is the mark? Your entry mark, Lijo 136. What if the 136 is mark of what? English and computer marks. So you want to get the result, Lijo. Second line, what do you have to get? This is a total, okay, symbol. Total marks of EM and CM is equal to this one. How we can rewrite the program? How we can rewrite? Anybody? Anybody? Anybody saying? Otherwise, I will say. No. Okay. So I will say. Okay. This is same only. So what I will do? I will write here in the printout statement. Okay. Printout statement. Here I will write. What I will write? Double inverted comma. Total of what is that? EM, no? EM and CM is okay. Is, then what I will do? I will close double inverted comma. Okay, then I will compile. What will happen here? When I will compile, what is happening there here? What you have seen this one? Oh, exactly. Here you see, in this line, there is an error. What would be the error?
Sir, after total of EM and CM is equal to EM plus CM.
It's okay. That is not a problem. Yeah, okay. No. So I want to use one, this one. What is the name of this one? Can you remember? Do you remember this one? Do you remember this one? What is the name of this one? Is it a plus?
Modulator.
Yeah. Oh, no, not modulator. Modulator and no. Con, K. Remember? What is that? Con, K, T, Ne. Thank God. Yes. Okay. So this is called concatenation. This is called what? Please repeat. What is the meaning of this one?
Concatenation.
Okay. But what is this one here? What is this one? In this statement, what is this one? This plus symbol. Addition symbol. Yes. So here in the statement is addition symbol. In the statement, it is an addition symbol, but when the system dot out dot, okay, if you use symbol here in the system dot out dot, this symbol name is concatenate. What is the function of concatenate? Okay, I will compile. Then from here to here, which type of variable? This is called what? What will, what type of values will write in double inverted comma just before I told?
So sentence.
Ah, string. Okay, which for string writing variable. Sentence, which data type will use to writing sentence or words? String. Which data type will use?
String.
Integer.
String. No, string only.
String, okay, string.
So this is a string. This is a string data type, and this is a variable. Here you see total, this variable. Okay, and this should come in the integer. So if we use multiple, we join string and integer variable to add this both, we use concatenation symbol. Where we use concatenation symbol? In system dot. Okay, now I'll compile. I will run the program and you will see what is the output of this one. I write one mark, some mark you write, and write one name. Okay, again, can you write JJJ? Simply, can you write JJJ? No, double inverted comma. Why? Because it's a string.
Double inverted comma.
Yes, click on. Okay, then what is the result came? The name is JJJ and it is coming there. Total of EM and CM is 151. The other program, only 156. Only that mark. Got it? Yes. What is the use of this one? Whatever we write in double inverted comma, it will print as it is in the print statement, system dot print. And if we use concatenation, this symbol plus symbol in a system, that we call concatenation, and other place in the statement we use as a addition. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Now,
yes, sir.
Okay, now,
yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Next program. The same program, the programmer should give the mark for English, programmer should give mark for computer and person's name also. Then how we can rechange this or rearrange the program? Anybody? None of typing everything. Public class add mark is same. Public static void main is same. Okay.
The total, in the, after the total, we should change or something.
After the total means after total means here.
Yes. No, sir.
Okay.
After EN is there, EM is there, no, sir. In that
here we have to change.
EM. No, sir. Down, sir. In the after here. The total EM. Yeah, sir.
No, okay, it's okay. Then any other way?
Sir, before integer total is equal to, before that only we have to add integer EM is equal to the
got it. Yes, yes. I don't know who is saying, but it is correct only. Okay, so what do you have to do here? We have to bring here. See, here errors are coming. If I change something else, errors are coming. Yes. Okay. Now, I delete cut from here. So, what you are supposed to write there?
String.
Here,
string marks.
String. Sorry. String. String arcs. String arcs. Then. Sorry. This bracket. No. This bracket. Correct. No. Yes. Then, any error? Is there any error? Compile again. One more error. What is that error? What is that error? See here, error. Can you find out what is the error?
Sir, value is not given.
Value. No. What is the error? Value I didn't give. Okay. So what is the error? Can you find here what it shows here? What is the error? See here. What is the error here? So first error, after each statement, the end of the statement, how it will terminate? Look here, what is that? What is the error?
Colon.
Ah, semicolon, not colon, semicolon. Each statement should end with the, that means that line will be terminate. Okay, terminate to the output page. Use this one. Again, compile. Everything is correct? No. Again, one more error. What is that error then? Not value. Value, no need. Okay, value, let it be. If I compile one more, what is that? So here, you cannot write like this one. Integer, integer, integer. So you have to bring, it's a different data type, means in different line, you have to write. String name, because this both are integer, this is string. So you have to bring in another one. What is error again here? What is error?
Sir, semicolon.
Semicolon, sir.
Again, semicolon here in the second line. Okay, again, I'll come back. Again, what is this one? Again, identifier expected. One more error. So this both are integer, correct? No? Both are integer variables. So what I have to do? Integer, comma. Now I will compile. Is it any error here? Error one. What is error here? No. Error. What is one more error here? What is error? Variable EM might not have been
initialized.
Oh, sorry.
Initialized.
If you are giving like this one, you have to initialize the value. Okay. If you are giving here, means no need, because user will give. Yes. So what I had to give, integer EM is equal to some mark, and a CEM is equal to some mark. Now I will compile. Is there any error? Again, one more error. What is that error? What is that error?
Name is not
Because if you put that in double inverted comma.
Name you have to give in double inverted comma. No, if when you give double inverted comma, you have to, this is your name, correct? No, yes. Then which symbol we have to use?
Plus.
Concatenation.
No, not plus. Don't say plus.
Concatenation.
Concatenation. So here you can get. Okay, then here what is the problem? No, here we didn't initialize, because we are typing the string name. So what is the string name? What is the name? Pijo. Is it okay? Error. What is the error here? This you know. You can understand.
Double
what is the error here? Exactly.
Double inverted comma.
Because that is a string. Yes. Got it. Compile. Now we will see. Is there any error? Yes. Void main string dot integer em cem, because both are integer only. String, we are given double inverted comma, integer total, and we put bring the output of name. Yes. String and total. Now you'll compile. I'll come back. Yes. Right click. Click on. Okay. Why here this nothing came here? When I click here, it is coming like this. Why?
Because
we declared and initialized the value in the program. Okay. So click on OK. Then the terminal page. What is the terminal page? Look here. Total of last one. Total of EM and CM. This is Lijo. Name is Lijo. Got it from here onwards. This is why it is in single line it comes. Why it is single line it coming?
LN.
Why it is coming?
LN.
Here. Yes. Here print LN is there. Here there is no print LN. Now I'll compile. Then I'll right click and give. And no need of giving anything, because you declared and initialized the variable. Click on OK. Now you will get the. What are you getting now? Now you look here. It's a new program is coming now. First line, this is name Lijo, and total name is 191. Okay. This is the terminal page. So this is it clear, children? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay.
Yes, sir.
I've been explaining. I am getting, wow, yes. It is a 950. So understood, this is the two, three things I told with this two program. We are adding two marks. Okay, and how the user can give in the main method, and the declared by the user, sorry, declared by the programmer and initialized by the user. And second one, declare and initialize by the programmer. Got it? Yes. And we use return type void. So whatever we write in system.out.print statement, in that one, whatever we write in the double inverted comma, as it is, it will print. And we use concatenation symbol, then we write the variable. Whenever you use string variable, we have to put in double inverted comma. Clear? This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now you have any doubts, now you can ask. I will go to small program, then print statement, not small program, editing of this program, then I will stop. Any doubts of this one, I will answer now. Nothing, I think. So I'll go to the again this page. Okay, look here, children. It is written there void main. What is main? Void is a return type. Main is a method. We can use only main. Only main with the as a is a method name. Only method name main can use.
No, sir.
Ah, it is a name. Name can be changed. Correct. So instead of void main, I use void show. Sorry. Void show.
So name can be defined by anything.
Yeah, anything. So this is a method name. This is a method name or function name. Function name you can change. See, I change it to main to show. Compile. No error. And I will go the page and I will compile. Okay. Look here. What is that? Parameters are used there. Yes, parameters are used. That program is one error is there. There it is. Yes, here show string. So parameters, this one we have to delete. Yes. Compile.
Sir, we should keep blank.
Yes, look here. This is your name, Lijojo. What is the Lijo? Total error mark is 81. Got it?
Yes,
got
sir.
It. So instead of show, you can give, can you give another, what is that? Detail. Can you give a detail? Yeah, of course.
Sir. Name.
Yeah, can you give mascot? Can you give mask?
Yes,
mascot. Can
sir,
you give
we can
like this?
Keep anything too. Yes, sir.
Can you keep, like this? Method name, function name like this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Is it right?
Sir, then after void, we can change, no, sir.
No, you can change, but this is right or not. Is there any error? Void mascot bracket. Is there any error? Error is correct.
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
Mascot
continuously.
Exactly. You cannot. This is a name. Identifier. Name. Identifier. We learn token. Identifier. Yes. Instead of space, you can use underscore. Or without. Otherwise, without space, you can use. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So these are, I'm not confusing too much. So this is enough for you for the first monthly test to learn. Please do practice. Okay. Practice. These are the practical things. It is a 9:54. Okay. Now I'm stopping here. If you have any doubt, I will explain or I will stop the class and please go through that video. When you click on video, no. And at top, there is an option there. You can, okay, little sir, boring class. You can forward. You want to know medium. So you can forward. Make it fast. Play fast. Okay. Play fast and play slow. You are not attending. Little sir is talking too much. Or the that sir is class is too fast. So there is a slow button. So you can use fast. You can use slow. Okay. So same way you can use. Okay. Anyway, thank you. Okay. Anything else? I will stop. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.